Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do this investment simple interest problem using two variables. I also did a video on it using one variable. So we're going to use two variables and a system of equations to solve this. So let's start by reading the problem. A total of $7,000 was invested in two simple interest accounts, such that the annual interest earned in each account was the same. The interest rates of the accounts were 15% and 20%. How much was invested in each account? All right, so it's not going to be the same amount because if I invested the same amount in each of these accounts, the interest would be different, right? You didn't earn more interest in the 20% account. Let's begin just by looking at the formula for simple interest. All right, so if we have the principal interest time, oops, I'm sorry, the principal, the interest rate, the time, and the interest earned, defined here P, R, T, and I, the basic formula is interest equals principal times rate times time. But if we're talking about 1 year, T is one, and we can write principal times rate or rate times principal. And we have a little example of investing $5,000 at 6% for a year, we would earn $300 in interest. So we're going to use this interest equals rate times principal for this problem. All right, so looking through this, we're trying to find two things. How much was invested in each account? So that's why this is a good problem to use two variables. So I like to keep my information in a chart. So I have two different kinds of accounts. I've got a 15% account and a 20% account. So I'm going to write my rate in, with using a percent. So 0.15 and 0.2 or 0.0. Now the principal. This is the easy part about using two variables, x and y. All right, we don't know how much it is, but we know the total amount is how much principal I put in the first account plus how much in the second account. So notice my total amount of money I have to invest is $7,000. That's going to give us our first equation. X plus y is going to have to add up to $7,000. All right, what about the interest earned? We know that to get the interest, you multiply the rate times the principal. So I have 0.15 times x for the interest earned in this account, the 15% account, and in the 20% account, we have 0.20y. All right, so we have to figure out what to do with this interest. So we look back up at the problem, and what's it say? It says the interest rates of the account, whoops, sorry. The annual interest earned in each account was the same. All right, so the interest earned in each account was the same. So how can we write an equation from our chart? Well, one equation is that the amount of money you invested added up to 7,000. So one equation is going to be x plus y equals 7,000. What's the other one? The interest earned is the same. Well, that means the interest from the 15% account is actually equal to the interest in the 20% account. So I have 0.15x equals 0.20y. So here are our two equations. Now, you can use either the substitution method or the elimination addition method, or you could graph it, which I wouldn't suggest. That would be the most difficult in this problem. But before doing either ones, I'm going to take the second equation and just make the numbers a little bit easier. All right, because I've got decimal points. So before I use the substitution or the elimination method, I'm going to multiply both sides of this equation by 100. So remember, I'm multiplying both terms on both sides of the equation, right? On each side. So I've got 100 times 0.15x. That'll move this decimal 2 to the right. And 100 times 20y. 0.20y will give you 20y, right? You move it to the right. And I'm going do one more thing. I notice there's a common factor on both sides, so I could divide out the common factor. So what number goes into both 15 and 20? 5. I'm just trying to make my arithmetic easier. If I divide both sides by 5, I get an even easier equation. 3x equals 4y. All right, so I've got x plus y is 7,000, and 3x equals 4y. All of these three equations you see on the right are equivalent to each other, right? So, how about using substitution? Because it's easy to solve for x or y over here on the left-hand side, and then we could plug that in to this equation 3x plus 4y. We'll plug either something in for x or we'll plug in something for y. It doesn't matter. Let's go ahead and solve for x, okay? In this equation, you want to do on the equation that's easy to solve for. So if I subtract y from both sides, that says x is 7,000 minus y. So I am going to plug 7,000y in for x in this equation. So let's do that. Let's plug in 7,000 minus y in place of x. So I've got 3. I'm sorry. Yeah, 7,000 minus y. So we're plugging in for x. So I have 3 times 7,000, 21,000 minus, don't forget to distribute your 3, minus 3y equals 4y. And then I'm going to add 3y to both sides. So I have the variables on the left, constants on the right. I'm sorry, just the opposite. Variables on the right. 7y equals 21,000. All right, last thing would be to divide by 7. I'm kind of running out of room here. I hope this works. Divide both sides by 7, and hopefully you see that y is 3,000. Okay, so I got y is 3,000. So now that I know what y is, right? Y is 3,000. I can plug that back in here to figure out what x is. So x will be 7,000 minus 3,000, or 4,000. So I'm putting $4,000, I'm sorry, x is 4,000 and y is 3,000. Let's go back up here and write that down. X is 4,000, so I'm going to write the principal over here because I have room. For x, we got 4,000, and y, we got 3,000. So what does that stand for? That stands how much money I am investing in the 15% account. For the 4,000, right? I'm investing $4,000 in the 15% account and $3,000 in the 20% account. So let's see if that makes sense. We go back to the original problem here, right? Here's the original problem. It says how much was invested in each account. So what we're going to write is we think it's going to be 4,000 at 15% and 3,000 at 20%, and then we're going to make sure that really is true, though. We'll check our answers. Okay, so here was our original problem, and we just found out that we think the answer is we're going to invest $4,000 at 15% and $3,000 at 20%. But let's make sure that gives us the same amount of interest in each account, because that was the key to this problem. The annual interest earned in each account was the same. So let's check the interest in each account. So the interest, I'm going to write that as the interest in the 15% account, right, would be what? 0.15 times 4,000. Oops. And that is going to be $600. It's really $4,000. And let's check the interest in the 20% account. That would be 20% I'm going to just write that as 0.2 times $3,000. And if you do that, you also get $600. All right, so you could do this by multiplying it out. You could change these to fractions. Let me show you how easy it is to change to do 0.15 times 4,000. 0.15 is really 15 hundredths times 4,000, right? So 100 into 4,000, that's going to cancel two of those zeros, right? So what do I end up with? I've got 15 times 4. Well, that's 60. And if you can't do that in your head, do 15 times 2 is 30 and then times 2 again. So you get 60 with the extra 0. See how easy that is? All right. Or you can get a calculator, or you could do it with decimals. You multiply 15 times 4, move the decimal the right number of places, etc. But we did check that the interest is the same. So here's the answer to our problem. We checked it. We did get the same amount of interest when we invested 4,000 at 15% and 3,000 at 20%, so that's the answer to our problem.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.